Okay, hello everybody, and welcome back to a rather delayed Dragon Age Inquisition video. I know it's been a long time, probably like a couple months since I've uploaded this, and I apologize. I know not a ton of you watch it, but those that do really seem to enjoy it. There will be some changes to the format now. I will still be probably streaming Talon's story, but I'm editing the streams down big time. I'm taking out any extra running around, any extraneous conversations that we just have on the stream, you know, just us talking about something random. I'll be doing my best to edit those out and just keep you with like the main stuff, or if something interesting happens or something interesting is said, I'll leave it in. But I will be editing them, which means they won't be coming out as frequently as I used to put them out every other day, because there's a lot of them and I have to watch. I mean, I spent the last like 24 hours editing. Like, this really, I've gotten it down from like 3 hours of footage to about an hour and 57 minutes. And so it's been a lot of editing. And there have been some audio sync issues because I had to rip it straight from Twitch. And that sometimes creates audio sync issues. So if you notice that, I apologize. I did my best to fix them. I will be finishing up Talon's story soon. I want to finish Jaws of Akan DLC and Trespasser DLC for sure. And of course, the end of the game. But I feel like his story has been going for a long time. And as much as I love him to bits, I do think, especially for recording purposes and entertainment purposes, his story probably needs to be wrapped up soon. But So I'm going to be finishing Jaws of Akan for sure. And right now, just so you know, for the next couple of episodes at least, I'll be doing companion quests, main mission type things. So nothing extraneous, really, as far as I can tell. I've been editing for a while, so the next couple of episodes at least will be like Blackwall's mission, Josephine's mission, stuff like that. Also, unfortunately, this is important, I was streaming for 3 hours one day and didn't realize, well, people mentioned it, but they said it wasn't too big of a problem and to keep streaming, so I kept streaming. But what happened is something was wrong with like my microphone or something. It was on my old computer, and my personal audio, my commentary was just glitchy as all crap. Like, it was like you could get like every third word I said. So to those people who are watching that stream, I'm terribly sorry. I was only able to watch like the first 10 minutes before I just lost my mind with embarrassment. I was like, I can't believe they put up with me doing that long. Unfortunately, I know for sure we did Cassandra's quest. So we're about to do, for the next couple of episodes, we're going to be doing Varric's, Josephine's, and Blackwall's. We're going to also do, we got Solas's war table mission done. So, which doesn't really do anything, it's not really that important, but I know for sure in the 3 hours, we went and took the keep, we retook the keep, and we took, what's that, the Tevinter area, where you have to go if you want to get the Darkspawn in the Western Approach. We went up into that area where there's like the ogres and stuff like that. We got that place done. So we finished Cassandra's fetch quest, and I believe we finished Blackwall's fetch quest. I'll have to double check. But yeah, so I know for sure Cassandra's is really, really interesting, and I'm pretty sure, unless I'm just mixing it up, which if I am, I apologize. But I'm pretty sure on this stream is when we did Cassandra's main mission, which is actually really important, or her companion quest, which is actually really influential for the entire plot of the game, I feel like. So I do apologize for that, and there might have been somebody else's. I know we've done Vivian's. It's been so long, I can't remember. I used to remember, I had it written down somewhere, and then I lost the paper, what exactly we did. So if there's something I'm missing, it's probably from that 3 hours. And I apologize, you guys can't, that you won't be able to see that, but, and this, it was so long ago, that's not even on Twitch anymore. Not that you want to watch it, because I could not, in good conscience, download it from Twitch, because my audio was so horrible in that one. But so there is that. So big things is I'm going to be editing the streams down now, the stream footage anyway, so that it's just basic important stuff. We're going to be heading into main mission stuff and companion quests here right now. And we did miss a couple of, for sure, Cassandra's quest and maybe a couple of other things from the 3 hours that I streamed but wasn't able to salvage. So, sorry this has been long. If you have any questions, let me know. I'm looking forward to tying up Talon's story. Eventually, I'd love to play him just with myself, with a custom world state. But his story's been great, and I'm looking forward to seeing how he's gonna react to everything at the end of the game. And I'm looking forward to seeing what you guys think. So thank you again for all your patience, especially concerning Dragon Age Inquisition, my second playthrough. I appreciate you guys' support for that. It's meant a lot to me that this series has done pretty well, and that you guys, even if it hasn't done well, that the people who watched it seem to like it. So, because I love this game. It's great, and I love Talon. He's a great character. Also, one last thing. There are some times where the stream dropped, and I think one time was during one of the Blackwall conversation at the bar. So it's going to have a little bit of a jump cut there, and I'll just be like, oh, look, here it is. But yeah, so there's a couple places where the stream dropped, and so we might end up in a place a little bit ahead of where we were, but it was never too terribly far. It was always really easy to notice and stop and then come back. And one last thing before we get to the actual video. Sorry this has been so long. But I did have a problem. When I ripped the footage from Twitch, unfortunately Twitch combines the game and commentary footage, so I can't regulate volume as compared to like my volume compared to the game volume. So unfortunately, my commentary is extremely loud compared to the game, and I had to like turn it way down. Also, because I was recording at a higher set volume, I peak a lot more. Like, there's a lot more, like, kind of, like, weird-sounding, higher, louder moments. So I had to turn the overall volume way down just on the whole thing. So the game audio is kind of quiet, and my commentary is kind of loud. So if you're wearing headphones, be prepared for that. I've tried to make this intro part about the same volume, so be prepared at this level, I guess, and if I, you know, if I get excited, I get a little bit louder, so I do apologize for that. Hopefully it's not too bad. It's gonna be for the next couple of episodes. I'll let you know when it stopped, but yeah, at the time I was recording too high because it was a new computer and all my settings changed, and I didn't quite realize how loud I was, so again, I apologize for that, but thank you guys. Thank you for putting up with this really long intro. If you got this far, I appreciate it. And once again, I will see you in a moment. Man, I have missed this game. And this is exciting. We're all back again. First things first, I need to make Dorian beautiful again. He is beautiful, but I need to maybe give him something a little more... oh my gosh, that's always terrifying when the faces don't render. I freaking hate that. So there's that one. I liked this one. So I think we're gonna keep it, but I might dye it. I might dye it a little. I honestly miss the black and gold look for him. So I think we'll go back to that. But it was fun. It was fun while it lasted. I'm sure Dorian just couldn't get enough of it. Color, no. Well, obsidian, maybe, or, not the dragon bone. Or no, it wasn't, I had it in silver and black, not silver and gold. What was, this is how we're gonna start out. Ooh, that looks cool. The white and the blue. I like it. We'll just constantly be changing his armor, because I'm obsessed. Yeah, let's do that. And I can't remember how to play this game. I've been playing Skyrim a lot. That's gonna mess me up. Let's take off his lovely hat. As beautiful as it is. Of course this is what we're doing right now. Can't ever not do inventory ever. Wait, oh wow, that black bow is better. It is better than the one I made for myself, that's right. I don't care. Oh, none of them are as pretty as mine though. Look how pretty mine is.
Welcome. We're testing out the new laptop that, thanks to you guys who were helping me out, I was able to afford. Plus, thanks to Black Friday, because this $900 laptop was half off. So,
So we're testing it out, seeing how it works. I'm also avoiding familial responsibilities, so happy days.
Oh my gosh, it's beautiful! Whoa!
Alright, well, let's put Winter's Breath and Estwatch Guard away. Let's hope. Okay, should we go pry into Varric's love life? I like it. Let's do it. Let's go, like, analyze his love life. Enter Valmar. Man, we get to go back to the hinterlands. I actually really like the hinterlands. Valmar, he's over here. Yeah. Let's do it. Okay, we're bringing Dorian. Who should we bring? His husband. Well, we gotta bring Varric. That's right. Varric. Shoot, who... Okay, we need to bring a warrior then. So Cassandra, Blackwall, or Iron Bull? Let's bring Cassandra. I've enjoyed bringing Cassandra out lately. I didn't bring her out ever... Well, I did in the beginning with my first character because, you know, you're stuck with Solas, Varric, and Cassandra. But... Which I don't mind. They're a good squad. They're funny. Obviously a really balanced team. This is the one you start out with. Woo! Oh, Dorian, you look fantastic. Oh, Cassandra, what kind of shield do you have? Oh, not armor. I think I put away and... Oh, she's only got... Did I accidentally put away her shield? I think I did. No, I didn't. Or did I give it? Did I give it? No. That's so strange. Well, I'll give her that one. It's huge. It is utterly massive. Okay, because I was like, what kind of shield was that she had? But it was just the basic starting shield. Oh man, Talon, you're gorgeous. I missed you. I haven't played this game in ages. Let's see, when did I last play this game? On the 4th? So yeah, almost a month. Jeez. It's been a while. It's because we streamed so much that last time that I didn't need to play again for ages. And I really could have gone probably another week or two without playing it again, but I like the game. That's a good point. Dang it. I just tried to jump how you jump in Skyrim by pressing Y. It's gonna screw me up. That, I mean, seriously, like, Varric's attachment to Bianca is a bit crazy. Bianca's excited to go see Bianca. Bianca is excited. There's so much excitement everywhere. I mean, really, I mean, I could see, I think he plays up the attachment to Bianca, but at the same time, I do think he's, rather attached to her. To the weapon. What is this? Oh, that's the mine. Oh, I was like, what is that shiny thing?
Lessonries? Looks like Carta. Lyrium smuggling would be profitable around here.
Okay. Well, let's go! In we go. I also do think that I put in Twitch alert notifications, so...
Finally. I started to think you weren't coming.
Nobody said you had to hang out in the creepy cave while you waited.
Well, I did wait, so let's make this quick. These idiots...
It has been a very long time.
...mountain unprotected containers. We don't want to stick around long enough for it to start talking to us.
Why would the containers need to be protected?
Lyrium is...
Talon, you're beautiful!
It can poison or kill dwarves, and we're resistant to it. Sometimes it just explodes. No warning.
Basically, only crazy people mine Lyrium.
The mining cast doesn't just sling it into a bucket. It's carried in special containers that keep it under control. And that's normal lyrium. The red stuff is worse.
Yep.
I wouldn't be surprised if most of their miners die just digging it up.
The pleasure of having an animal, but we do love them. Yes. Well, I don't even know how he tripped over it. It's all flat against the floor, and then he's like, "Wow!"
You know more about the effects of red lyrium than most.
Varric told me plenty about what it did to him, and his brother.
How did you find this operation in the first place?
I just absolutely hate how the male elf arms,
this entrance in the past,
the body shape does that weird thing where they like.
Oh, I've got to admit, I was pretty surprised when I came here and found it full of humans.
We'd better get to work.
Sounds good to me.
Yay! I don't need a key to Valmar. That's funny. I got in already.
Must be an old dwarven outpost. What was it for? Trade, maybe? Your guess is as good as mine.
Oh, you're right. Does Bianca actually have hair? I have read the comic, because it seems like it's all hood. No, I've read the comic, and she does have, she has hair. I was gonna actually keep on... I kind of want to keep on helmets. Friendly fire, enable burst, put that on. Where's the... No, I'm not trying. Hide helmet. Oh, helmets are always hidden during conversation. No, because I want to see Talon with his helmet, with his hood on during a conversation. I think he'd look really hot. Look very mysterious. Woo! That was loud! Holy crap, that was loud! I see you. Now you're dead. Oh, there's more of you coming! Let's see if I can remember how to play this game. Like, at all. Bianca, you're not being much help! Yeah, I think she must have short hair or hair in a ponytail. Actually, for a really long time, I thought that, Leliana had long hair because I never saw her without her hood. And then in Inquisition, in Origins, I realized she actually has very short hair. And I was like, oh. This is not being too difficult. It's gonna be interesting having Varric with his mines out. I don't know if they're really doing us any good. I remember this place. I remember being just blown away at this place. The lighting and everything, it's gorgeous. I'm going to fall off. That taunts me. It taunts me. That looks like I could totally get to it. I think, can you? No? Dude, look at that. Look at that. It's like perfectly reasonable to assume you could get over there somehow. Oh, can I? Can I? If I just keep going? Maybe. Say, I know there was something. Something over here. Oh, is that it? Over here? Okay. Man, it'd be really cool to see Origins remade. Like, I was just thinking, the first time I ever played, like, I ever got my hands on Origins, well, the first time I ever played, I did a Dalish Elf. But when I started to play again, I actually became a Dwarf Commoner. And, I mean, Orzammar was cool looking. But can you just imagine it in, like, Inquisition graphics? Like, going to Orzammar as a Dwarf Commoner and, like, this is what you see? Like, except intact and everything? It would be amazing. It would be amazing. I don't think that's even possible to make like a mod for that, but And they were even saying, they were like, oh, we might do, only opened by some sort of mechanism. We'll do, Mass Effect. Mass Effect 1 and 2, we'll remake it. And I'm like, could you actually just remake Dragon Age Origins and 2? Not remake it, but, with, like, remaster it. I'm like, could you just remaster Origins and 2? I realize that might be a lot more work, but Mass Effect 1 and 3 and 2? They're basically fine. Especially 2. I really don't see why you'd bother. Maybe 1, but... doesn't seem like that big a deal. I'm also a little bit weirded out that nobody seems to chat much here. I mean, I don't know. And why aren't you guys moving? You guys aren't following me. Is it because I'm invisible? Excuse me. I think it was because I was invisible. They weren't following me. You can't go back to Origin. Camera controls are even more janky than Inquisition. I'm not talking about janky camera controls. We're going to talk about Dragon Age 2. I mean, yeah, I had the repeating dungeons and like the stupid enemy combat thing, but... the camera controls were super weird in Dragon Age 2. I think Origin's just fine. Part of the thing is that because of the way it's made and it's like not very intuitive, it just increases the challenge, which is kind of fun. But it is annoying. We should be secure enough from outsiders and more concerned about attracting darkspawn from the lower levels. Barricade the bridge. Wow! This is so nice. This is my first time seeing this in the PC. This is super nice. Oh, hey, look. Cassandra, you can break a wall. Yay. I want to sit on the throne. That's a cool looking... I like that motif back there. That's really cool looking. Looks kind of like flames. I want a dwarf throne. Do I get a dwarf throne? Oh, they are all programmed to hang back when you're in stealth, so you can do sneaky kill stuff. Okay, pitch grenade recipe. That's where it is. Ah! My goal with this character is to get every single grenade. Wait. Well, okay. My bad. Every single grenade recipe and stuff. Pitch grenade. Explodes into a puddle that slows enemies. How interesting. What really bums me out about Inquisition, and if there was a mod for this, I would get it in a heartbeat, is that you can only take out, like, 2 grenade tonic
so this is what you do now?
Things.
Beg pardon?
Skulking around in caves, shooting guys. Is this your day-to-day?
I usually try to avoid the caves.
I don't blame you. You haven't had good experience with caves. At first, I thought it was just because he tried to avoid, like, you know, his... like, when I first played and hadn't played Dragon Age 2, I thought it was because he didn't really want to be... like, he was like, I'm not that kind of dwarf. Like, don't assign that to me type thing. Or, like, I don't know. But, like, he's like, I'm not your stereotypical dwarf. But now I'm pretty sure it's partly because of that and partly because he had a really bad experience in a cave. Angry note about people trying to steal some. Defaced Carter notice. Much of Valmore reigns close to us. Anyone interested in that? Stop wasting time on the door. Don't care what's behind it. We're shorthanded. I think the place used to be a trade post. There's going to be something valuable behind that door. And just how will you make me sorry? I'll use my imagination and knives. You started Origins, restarted Origins not long ago. You unlocked the Codex in Orzammar. That mentions a dwarf named Shepard. Oh, I've heard about that one. But I never found it when I was in the Deep Roads. And I canvassed the Deep Roads pretty thoroughly, I feel like. Like, freaking way too thoroughly. But I've heard about that one and I've never seen it. I'm gonna find it next time. I'm gonna find it. Because that would be so funny. Like, I think I kind of...
these won't be the last.
That's not dark.
We may be too close to the surface for these to count as deep roads. But have I mentioned I hate the deep roads?
could count on you to, like, not turn on me, that'd be great, but I'm pretty sure you're just gonna not. You're gonna just start firing on me, even though we have more important concerns. Oh, Ben, there's a lot of things in there. I love all of, like, not particle effects, I don't know, but, like, just stuff that goes flying when you're fighting. So much magic and skills and stuff. Hello? Let's see, what is this? This is cool. Is this the door? Looks like it might have been a door that got knocked in, but there's still a door here. Hi! You just spawned in? Jeez. I also do have the trial on that gives my enemies extra abilities. We'll see. See how that goes. Fall. I think I've completed one. Whoa. I've completed one mosaic. This looks suspicious. Oh, yeah. Need gears to get into that door. Darkspawn shield. This is a cool room. Oh, it's definitely a tomb. And there's probably ashes here, maybe? And those are... No, they don't burn, they're dead. Oh, hey, another door.
You had me worried, you know.
What did I do now?
That letter you sent me about the Red Lyrium was the first I'd heard from you since the Chantry explosion.
Had it been that long?
Seriously, if you died in that mess, I'd have come back to Kirkwall and dug you up just to kick your ass.
What would you do if I'd been cremated?
Kick your ashes, of course.
I'm a little bit iffy on Bianca, to be honest with you. Just because I'm not quite sure she has any right to be all, I don't know, lovey-dovey-ish? Not, I mean, they're friends, right? But, like, she's the one who abandoned him, sort of. I don't know. At the same time, it doesn't really matter. It is what it is. Yeah, let's hope this wooden plank holds the darkspawn back. Good golly. You found it a little after or a little before having met the Legion of the Dead? Alright, I'll keep an eye out for it next time for sure. There was probably a little nook or cranny that I missed. Oops, I keep acting like this is Skyrim. Map. Open the locked door. What's that one? I don't want to, like, progress the story quite yet. I want to get the whole place explored. But I can't remember if this is the door that does it or not.
How is what's his name?
Bogdan? He's in Navarra right now, selling my machine to wealthy landowners.
I heard some of the guild were trying to get you named a paragon for that contraption.
That's not gonna happen.
Look at Talon's all lit up weird.
Smith Bronca ever was. A surfacer paragon? Never.
You think they do quite a bit of meeting up from time? Do you think so? I mean, that just seems like it would be painful for everybody involved.
I built these doors. They probably shut this one from the other side when they heard the ruckus we were making. Ta-da.
You've been here often enough to renovate the cave.
You already know I've used this entrance in the past. I don't know if Varric's told you, but the Merchant's Guild is cutthroat. Literally. I built the doors to keep rivals from following me down here and arranging accidents.
Admitted, you've been waiting to do that since we arrived.
Of course I was.
Whoa.
After you.
Magic-y, magic, magic. Whoa, what? Where did you come from? Okay, well, first I want to go find the other gear. now that we've established that. I thought, when I first played this and I met Bianca, I was like, oh, I don't think it's a problem. Like, she obviously still cares for him, despite whatever they had in the past, you know? And wow, that was funny. She's like waddling over. And then I read the comic, or one of the comics, and it gives a little bit of a stronger hint as to what is going on, or what happened. And I was like, oh, that's really sad. You know? Like... Yay! Oh my gosh, I just destroyed you all. Oh wow, who is this? Who is this? I've been stunned! Holy crap! Where are you people? I think this is also one of the only times where you ever actually fight dwarves is here. Because you never really see them out and about. You never see them, you're not fighting them, they're not like bandits or anything. Which kind of did surprise me, but... Dwarfing gear. Excellent. Use the gears to open this bolt? What about the other one? Oh, right. This one talks about the how important surface dwarves are for the economy. Let's do it. Oh, use the gears to open it. Oh yeah, the comic. Because what you see is basically Varric gets sucked into the Fade, along with a couple other people. And they're trying to tempt, like, he's being tempted, right? He's being tempted to stay instead of go back. And his dream is basically him and Bianca getting ready to run away together. And her coming, and, she comes to him, or they wake up together or something. And, they're getting ready to take a boat and leave. And Varric realizes it's a lie, it's a fake, it's a dream. Because in real life, Bianca never showed up to the meeting place. She didn't even say anything. She just, like, they were gonna run away together because they weren't supposed to fall in love or whatever, you know? But they did. And when they were supposed to run away together, she never showed up. And so, you know, Varric is, like, you know, obviously tempted to stay there, but he has to get out and go. But I felt really bad, like, that happened. Like, I thought it was maybe a mutual decision on both their parts to not run away together, like, for whatever reason, and then she marries this guy she doesn't love because, you know, it's better for her family or whatever, but she just doesn't really ever give a reason, and she just gets married to this other guy. And I was like, oh, that's really sad. Like, just the way she handled it, you know? Obviously, it's a complicated situation. Maybe it's... In a fairy tale, you hope. You're like, oh, everything for love or whatever. But Dragon Age is really good about not being a stereotypical fairy tale in many ways. And in that, you know, a lot of times, the main characters of certain things don't have happy endings. Oh, this was that door. Oh, okay. And I may be butchering it. I don't know. I might be oversimplifying the story, but it just made me really sad. And then she always is like semi-flirting with him, and like he's obviously never let go of her, like never let go of her memory, and he still loves her, and I think she still loves him, but she married this guy and I don't know. It's just sad. It's just sad. It's a sad story. I think it does explain pretty well why Varric is unromanceable. Like, you can't... Because people are like, I want to romance him. But he's definitely really hung up on an old love. So, it makes sense. That comic was really interesting. I would definitely... If you ever feel inclined, definitely... I got, like, the volume or whatever. Volume 1. And it was really interesting. Really cool stuff. Can I just...
should seal the tunnel before more darkspawn join us.
Yeah, we already did that. I got Mage Killer too, which came out recently. Oh, that's not what I meant to do. What? Oh no, I messed up. I messed up. Come on. You're invisible, but you're frozen, so. Yeah, the comics, they have a lot of, like, the comics and the books.
Kind of like old times.
I don't recall us ever shooting people together.
Remember crashing Bartram's guild dinner? We might as well have shot him.
This isn't nearly as dangerous as pissing off my brother.
Oh, I just read it, but I didn't see it. A different darkspawn? Oh, I bet you that's something about the talking darkspawn. Sounds good. Yeah. Well, it's more than that. Varric's the one narrating the comic. It's got Isabella, Varric, and Alistair, actually. And it talks about the fate of Alistair's dad. And in Dragon Age canon, basically, Alistair is the king, whereas in mine, Alistair's still a warden. But it's King Alistair, Varric, and Isabella in this comic, and it's quite interesting. No, get that one. Run away! Dude, did that like rogue just get guard? Cassandra, you're so beautiful! Can't wait to romance Cassandra sometime. I'm trying to keep an eye on the enemies to see if they are actually... Oh, hey! That's right! They've got, like, wardens down here! That's right, because I'm like, who's throwing magic at us? Oh my gosh. I'm trying to see if I can tell if any of the enemies are actually, like, acting differently. Perfect. Come on. It's hard to tell though, because battle is always like, wah, it's so hectic.
How long are you gonna be in Orlais, do you think?
As long as this weird shit is going on, at least. Maybe longer. Why?
You'll have to stop by before Bogdan gets back. You should see my new workshop.
I'll see what I can do. You know your family will kill me if I stop by, right?
They're not gonna kill you.
You always say that, and they always send assassins.
Well, and that, like, she's always trying to bring it, like, she refuses to let him let go, it seems like. He refuses to let go, but she also refuses to let go. Like, she refuses to let go, she refuses to let him let go, he refuses to let go. It just seems like a very, kind of an unhealthy relationship, but, I mean, you know, they're friends. Like, you can't just drop that. Like, they were important to each other. Like, I don't know. It just seems like a very complicated situation, to be perfectly honest. Come, let me have it. Nope, I don't want it. Sure, why not? Okie dokie.
There you are. Won't be able to use this entrance again.
Bianca.
Ha, Varric.
You want to say something, Varric?
Andraste's ass, Bianca. You're the leak?
When I got the location, I went and had a look for myself. And I found the red lyrium, and I studied it.
You know what it does to people.
I was doing you a favor. You want to know how this stuff works just as much as I do. I just... wanted to figure it out.
She's curious.
How did you go from studying red lyrium to giving the location to Corypheus?
Oh, Talon, he's beautiful.
It has the blight.
It has the blight!
What? The two deadly things combined to form something super awful?
Lyrium is alive, or something.
We know that, actually.
It doesn't infect minerals, only animals.
Are we gonna mention that?
I couldn't get any further on my own, so I looked for a Grey Warden mage. Blight and magical expertise in one, right?
Which normally would have been a good idea.
He seemed really interested in helping my research. So I gave him a key.
Larius? He was the Grey Warden we met in Corypheus's... Oh, shit.
Yeah.
I knew something seemed off.
I didn't realize until you said you found Red Lyrium at Haven. I came here and, well, then I went to you.
Yeah. What?
That name means something to you, Varric.
He was at the Grey Warden prison where we
That's right!
Corypheus.
That's right!
He wasn't a mage before.
That's right! I was trying to remember. I'm like, where exactly is Larius from? But he's that guy who we were helping.
You had to know we'd figure out what happened, Bianca. Why did you insist on coming with us?
Varric told me what people were doing with the Red Lyrium. I had to help make this right.
I don't know what to say. Middle?
You told Varric you had a lead, so we'd straighten out your mistake.
I know I screwed up, but we did fix it. It's as right as I can make it.
This isn't one of your machines. You can't just replace a part and make everything right.
No, but I can try, can't I? Or am I supposed to wallow in my mistakes forever, kicking myself? Telling stories of what I should have done.
And that's a good point.
As if I would tell stories about my own mistakes.
Yeah, Larius was the mad one. Yeah, he was the one who was kind of hunched over and was had been stuck in there and had eaten darkspawn flesh or whatever. And then at the very end, he starts talking differently and after we've killed Corypheus and he walks away. And it's because Corypheus actually possessed him. And because he was a warden, and he was able to hop down into him, because he had the blight, and he's able to hop on into Larius. Get a room, you two. But I don't know.
What's done is done. There's no point arguing about it.
Yeah.
We've done all we can here. Bianca, you'd better get home before someone misses you.
Varric.
Don't worry about it.
Get him killed, and I'll feed you your own eyeballs, Inquisitor.
And at first I was like, oh, that's nice. Like, she's sweet. She cares about him. And now I'm like, you're the one who hurt him. Like, you know? And that seemed pretty final. Like, I don't know, people are thinking that maybe, I think I've heard something where people think that maybe now Varric will start to move on from Bianca. But at the same time, that seems like a bad way to end it, like, right there, you know? Get a room, I know, right? I think that's the one I chose with Erica, because she's a jokester. She's a little bit more humorous than Talon is, so... I don't try to be a jerk with Talon, but he is a bit blunt and straightforward.
I'm glad to have answers, but shit.
Yeah.
The second she showed up here, I knew. I let this mess happen. I gave her.
He takes so much on himself.
I'm not good at dealing with shit like this.
I don't think anyone is equipped any better than you are.
No, the point is, I don't deal with things.
If
Cassandra hadn't dragged me here, I'd be in Kirkwall right now pretending none of this was happening.
You realize that nothing has actually been stopping you from doing that.
I suppose you're right. Thank you for your help back there.
After all this, do you think you'll see Bianca again?
I always do.
There's that. So, okay, that's good. Hello. Oh, again. Oh, are we gonna play like a Grace?
There you are. I've been looking all over for you. You're just in time.
Yay! We're gonna play Wicked Grace!
We couldn't have that, could we?
Do I even know what he's talking about? I don't. Hey, it was dark!
Look who showed up, everybody. deal him in, would you, Ruffles?
Calling it a tankard!
It's been ages since I've played a game of Wicked Grace.
Grab a seat. We're ready to start.
Are we playing cards or what?
Are three drakes better than a pair of swords? Ugh, I can never remember.
Seeker, remember how I said, don't show anyone your hand? That rule includes announcing it to the table.
He has a crown on his head, but a sword too. His head didn't want either.
Don't talk to the face cards, kid.
You seem to have enough people. I have 1,000 things to do.
No, Cullen!
Using money can be both relaxing and habit-forming. Give it a try.
Curly, if any man in history ever needed a hobby, it's you.
Naked Cullen! That's right, Lemonsy!
I believe I'll start at... Oh, 3 coppers.
3 coppers!
Do you think that's too daring? Maybe I'll make it 1. No. Boldness. 3 it is.
Seriously, who starts at 3 coppers? Silver or go home.
Sounds good. I'm in.
Bolder the better, right? I'm in.
Me too. Well, are you in?
Heck yeah!
I'm in, and raising another silver.
You haven't even looked at your car.
Our illustrious leader is betting we're bluffing.
You are bluffing.
Oktoberfest is every day in Skyhold.
Dining hall and nothing but his knickers and this profound silence.
Naked color. Ooh, yes, Eshu.
70 mages and 30 Templars all turn to stone.
I've heard you can win the. I thought you had to be Josephine's significant other.
Until every soul was on.
Maybe to win.
A standing ovation.
What did he do?
Saluted, turned on his heel, and marched out like he was in full armor.
He did not.
He did not.
Good man.
Yeah, you do have to be in a romance with Josie.
That's how you know it's true. In a book, too unlikely.
A Dragon Age tankard? That thing was massive. That was bigger than his head. I actually got for my birthday, one of my friends gave me an Inquisition tankard. It's like a mug. It's a mug, Lemonsy, basically. But it looks like a tankard. It's a ceramic tankard. It's really nice. I think he got it from like one of the geek stores online. I need more drinks. Now you tell what. This says Varric. Yeah.
I think it's our professional storyteller's turn to tell one.
I think I can manage that.
Ooh!
Did I ever tell you about the time we broke into Chateau Hay? It started, as most capers do, with a trap.
With a trap. Oh, Varric is so good at this! Last time Erica told a story, but I figured Talon would probably not be the storytelling type.
Looks like the Duke. Fallen from grace.
You know, that's almost perfect for him. And the dealer takes everything. I win again.
Oh, she's so sneaky.
I figured out your tells, Lady Ambassador.
Commander, everyone knows a lady has no tells.
She is so scary.
Your good fortune lasts one more hand.
Deal me in.
I want another chance to win my dignity back. Deal me in.
Ashley! Hello! It's me! Look, it's Naked Cullen!
I tried to warn you, Curly.
Varric's like about to lose it.
Against an Antiva, Commander.
I don't want to witness our father's walk of shame back to the barracks.
Well, I do.
It comes off. I didn't know it came off.
And Dorian's like, yeah, I want to see this. He's like, please leave. Talon's like, okay, I'll turn around.
I'm glad you decided to join us. It's too easy to mistake you for the Inquisitor.
You're mistaking me for me. How much did you have to drink?
It's
easy to forget you're not just an icon or symbol. Like those statues of Andraste holding bowls of fire.
Oh boy, thanks.
At least it is for me. You up for another game when this is all over, Inquisitor?
Heck yes. That seems dangerous.
Every time I play, I increase the odds of winding up like...
You're never more alive than when you're about to lose your pants, my friend.
You're never more alive than when you're about to lose your pants.
Did I win?
I'm surprised. I don't think Sarah would ever get drunk under the table. And then Dorian leaves, but Bull stays. Yeah.
He was their enemy the whole time, but she made him forget so he could change.
Oh my gosh. What one is this one? It's like pop culture references.
Goodbye.
I can't remember. Just gonna run through and double check everybody really quick. We should be fine, but.
You seem very interested in my opinions.
Of course I am.
I need to talk to you.
Just talk? Such a pity.
Let's hang out.
Let's do something interesting.
More interesting than wandering the countryside killing random strangers?
Perish the thought.
But if you insist, a game of wicked grace.
Yay!
Time to take all your coin.
Thanks. Thanks for taking it. Do I have anything to drop off? Yay, I did. Do I have anything? No Nutella for you, Kaiook? You wouldn't have grapes other than at breakfast, and you're trying to drink alcohol before noon. I prefer pancakes to crepes.
A message from Divine Justine.
Ooh, shoot! It's a trap.
Don't trust it. We have enemies who would trick us like this.
No, it's genuine. She and I have a series of clues we include in our correspondence precisely for this reason. This message was written months, perhaps even years ago, to be delivered to me if she died.
Jay, yikes!
Such contingency plans. A sudden death often leaves loose ends. I'm to go to Valence, a small village on
the... Too bad I've hardened, Leliana.
There is something hidden there.
You've missed Dora. I've missed Doria too! I know, I might go kiss him later. I actually really have missed him. Nutella on toast. I love Nutella on pancakes. Nutella on pancakes. How do you hate the taste? It's chocolate.
Looking for.
The divine was a powerful woman who used her position to obtain all sorts.
It is chocolate. It's basically chocolate.
Very likely benefit the Inquisition, and must be kept from falling into the wrong hands. If I'm lucky, she will have instructions for me.
Oh shoot. I could be a jerk. Have I been enough of a jerk to, like, have the jerk option? Jeez.
Why hide things in Valence? What's so
special? Valence!
Justinia was revered mother at the chantry there for many years before she became the divine. It is a place that holds great meaning for her.
Hmm.
Is this you asking permission to leave for a bit?
Well, yes. I can't imagine I'll be away from my post for very long. And I was hoping you would agree to come with me.
Of course.
Will you at least consider it?
Yes, yes.
One more thing. If what is hidden in Valence is as valuable as I think, we're not going to be the only ones looking for it. I shall meet you at the chantry in Valence. Try not to...
Maybe we should do that. Okay, let's hop on that train. Jeez.
Did you need something?
You are well connected.
You seem to know a great many people.
I have made friends.
Okay.
And on occasion enemies. It's unavoidable.
Tell me about Waragon! Ooh, we haven't done this yet.
I first met her when we were traveling with a hero of...
Is it made out of the cocoa plank?
Can be a power. Just never forget that she's here. Work with her.
Learn from her.
Trust her if you must.
But not chocolate! Kaiook is very adamant. Not chocolate. According to Google, it's a type of chocolate spread. No, it's not chocolate. Europe loves it, it seems like. They have whole stores dedicated. Yes, they do.
Actually, no. Freaking what? Wait, what? I was thinking of the other chocolate stores. They have a whole store dedicated to Nutella? Oh, man, that sounds like heaven. I used to not like it, and then I ate it, and then I loved it, and it was...
Continue this conversation later.
I eat it out of the can. I don't even have to put it on anything. I just eat it straight out of the can. Blackwall, how's it going? Figured we had to catch up with you. Shoot, have we? No. We haven't! We haven't had the Blackwall thing yet!
Want a drink? I've a hankering for comfort.
Oh my gosh, I didn't realize! The chocolate is just behind, Shashu looks with envy at the door of the kitchen. Oh man, be careful. Okay, have fun, Ashley. We'll see you in 30 minutes. Blackwall's gonna be sad.
When I was a boy, there were these urchins who roamed the streets near my father's house. One day, they found a dog.
This is just really depressing drinking conversation.
I caught it, tied a rope around its neck, and strung it up. Do you know what I did?
You stopped them? Cut the dog down?
I did nothing. Not a damn thing. It was crying. I saw
the talk with Blackwall, capital letters.
And I turned around, went inside, and closed the door. I could have told my father, or alerted someone. I just pretended it wasn't happening.
You and Varric should talk.
You couldn't have been the only one there. No one else stepped in.
Doesn't make what I did any less wrong. I may as well have tied the noose myself. We could make the world better. It's just easier to shut our eyes.
Indeed. What would I say, Stonesmith? What would I say in real life if someone told you this? Honestly, if it was Blackwall, I would have been like, you know, like I would have assumed right off the bat that he'd cut the puppy down, like, you know, made sure it was okay. And then, you know, when he didn't, I would have been extremely surprised, honestly. And in real life, if somebody just walked up to me, if one of my friends walked up to me and said this, I don't think I'd be angry. It would be disappointing in many ways, but let's just stare at Talon's face because he's beautiful for a second. But no, I think, especially as a child, as an adult, I think I would feel a bit more like, you know, seriously, like you didn't do anything. But even as an adult, there's peer pressures and everything. And like, for maybe not for this specific kind of situation about a dog, but like as a kid, like your childhood is shaped so much by like what other kids think of you in a lot of ways and what they're doing. And as just one person against a group of kids, like, a younger kid, like, isn't... I don't know. I think I would be more sympathetic, but... I don't know. I would... And you can't do anything about it now. It was back in the day, you know? I don't know. Also, I think Stonesmith or somebody asked, am I gonna be going, like, all forward with Leliana's evil plan? I'm not sure yet. I have to hear her say it again. Your eyes aren't shut.
When we first met, you were saving peasants from demons and outlaws. You're not a man who shuts his eyes. A little insane, maybe?
Of course you'd make light of it. You make saving the world look easy. The rest of us can only dream of...
I can only do what I do because of the support of my friends. And just because I just...
It's not just
I just do it.
Back then.
Okay, here's one of those places where that I mentioned in the beginning where it cut out in the middle of one of the conversations with Blackwall. Luckily, it was close to the end, but it just, I mean, there's not even, I can't even just show you, like, quiet footage. It just completely dropped it. So, I guess we're gonna end it here because where it starts off next, we're still in the tavern and it's just me being like, oh, we're back now. So, I guess I'll end this part here since it's about an hour. But thank you guys for watching. I appreciate it. If you haven't seen the Blackwall conversation, there's tons of places on YouTube you can watch it. You can even watch it on my old channel if you can find the video. But thank you guys. Let me know what you think about this new kind of format, what you think. I know the audio is going to be screwy. Let me know in the comments if I'm still too loud, if you can't turn your computer down enough to, like, not hear me screaming all the time. And I'll fix it for the next one. But yeah, let me know what you think. If you think it's a good idea to be like, you know, cutting stuff out and making it a bit more compact and only with the relevant things, and just know that the audio stuff will hopefully soon be fixed. I'm still editing the Dragon Age footage that I have. I've only fully edited, I think there's 3 more hours past this hour that we've just got of this kind of footage. So it's full of important things. Unfortunately, it's a bit weird audio wise, but let me know what you guys think, for sure. And I'll try to fix anything I can for the next one. So thank you again. I will hopefully see you in the next one.